MACUMBA. The sighing dwarf is here again. He follows me from room to room, clearing his throat in ardent disapproval as I studiously pick my nose. He sports a shabby pinstriped suit and pencil-thin moustache. Sweat marks round his collar cause me considerable discomfort. Only rarely does he leave my flat, and works intermittently, I have a feeling, for Lucasfilms, inhabiting the latex livery of ugly extraterrestrials in Star Wars sequels. I can picture him on camera, dribbling copiously at rehearsing deadly stunts. His mission is unusual in this singular regard. He simply stands at hip height to me, oozing nothing short of total disapproval for my every move. I know his name to be MACUMBA, but do not know how I know it. I do my best to ignore him, but he is doggedly determined in his quest. Often, when I make my way to the kitchen to prepare a meal for myself, and know I've left him sitting on a scatter cushion, cross-legged, flicking through my recent poems, and do not hear his silent passage down the hallway, just when I am feeling more relaxed, busily trimming black currants and cutting feta into tiny squares, I feel his criticism of my knees turn and wait. A deep, despairing, drawn-out sigh. I do not want to know the reason for his condemnation, and shall not ask him. I fear that he will then take over, adding verbal contamination to my every move and relaxed gesture. The prospect of him using words to me is quite terrible. The sigh is bad enough. It is like regret in that latest hour for one's deepest need left unfulfilled. If he comes to hear about this piece, I dread how things could be affected. I shall keep it hidden from him on the high shelf of the cupboard on the common stair. I do not know how many active dwarves there are. Perhaps most people have one. If you do not have a dwarf like mine, then let me warn you, implore you, not to sigh on your journey home tonight. I fear that this could be a tracking signal for MACUMBA and his kin